So welcome back, everyone. Mike here. I have some wonderful news to report to all of you. No, the swimming pool manufacturers did not find a resin supplier, so we still have no idea when we're getting a swimming pool. The good news I have to report today is I finally found the proper place to set up a camera to better show what I have been trying to explain for the last week or so. Since I installed that big cistern tank over there, I have received hundreds of comments, emails, Facebook messages from a lot of different people saying that the tank's not deep enough, it just didn't look right, it looked like this is rising up. And I get it, I do. Things on camera look a little bit different than what they really are sometimes. For example, if you stand over here, from here it looks like it's rising up. Or if you stand down there, from here it looks like the tank's sticking out of the ground and I didn't bury it deep enough. But as you can see, if you look at the top of your screen, you'll see the roof line of the building. It shows that the camera is level. Then if you look at the lower left of your screen, you can see that cistern tank. Finished grade is right here where the concrete's going to go. So I need this side here to be about 4 or 5 inches below that, somewhere right in here. And hopefully with this view, you can see how this dirt will go out over there and provide plenty of cover over top of that tank. The goal here is to have as much level, flat ground out here as I can. You know, the original plan was to take the dirt from the swimming pool, blow it out over top of that, have a nice big level spot. But since we don't know when the pool's coming, that's why I'm hauling this fill up here. But I want to get all this done, get the road in, and we're going to be pouring the concrete here under the patio the same time we do inside the building. So I want to get all this ready out here, put some topsoil on it, get it seated, and this will be done ready for the wedding. So that's the plan. So hopefully we can now put that discussion to bed and move on to the next one. And sometimes you're just going to have to trust me. Now keep in mind, although I'm not a professional, I am a licensed and certified weekend warrior. Before I put any more fill on this, we're going to put these pipes on here. This is just a cap sitting right on here. This will be the filler, the fill tube, I guess you could say. This is 4 inch here. And the water line going into the building, it's over in here. It's already covered up. Don't want to drop anything in there. That is 7 feet deep to the bottom of this tank. And I mentioned it before, and we actually did a video on it, but this tank came from Key Precast in Shakora, Pennsylvania. Really, really pleased with those guys. Nice family-owned business. They do great work. I want to screw this up in case Plumber Jim's watching. Plenty of glue. That's beautiful. Now here we've got 3 inch. This will be the vent. I just have a cap for it now. I need to find a decent vent, a good vent to put on top of it. Thank you. So I don't know if I mentioned or not, but the water line, it's over there. It's already buried. I used 2A limestone to kind of cover it all up just to help protect it a little bit when I'm backfilling this. And I'm going to do the same thing around these. I think what I'll do is bring that BX over, bring some dirt over here right up against the tank, and then leave kind of like a pocket here and put at least a foot of that 2A limestone in here. That can be a real bugger when you're backfilling. You know, you get a big clump or something and you hit one of these pipes, you could break it off, and I don't want to do that. All right, now I'm going to put these manhole risers together. I have 2 of them right now. I'm going to need one more. But they go together with these stainless screws, and then there's gaskets around each one of them. Once again, I'm going to try not to drop anything. Here's the lid. I'm going to go ahead and screw that down as well. Then I'll just take it off when I get another riser. But you can kind of see that gasket right there. And then those screws secure it down. But it's a pretty good setup there, really. Nice little system. I'm used to the old concrete risers. I think what I'm going to do, even though stone is kind of pricey, it's cheap insurance, I'm going to put that 2A limestone all around that riser as well. Huh. You learn something every day. I didn't know what these holes were for. They're about 3 inches deep and they bought them out. Says right on it. I'm not big on reading instructions, but it says insert number 4 rebar here for underground metal detection. So if you're using this riser for your septic tank and you had it covered with dirt, a couple pieces of rebar in there, run your metal detector over it, you would know exactly where the lid is so you're not digging up your whole yard. Nice little added feature there. Looking at it now, I don't even think I'm going to put another riser on it. I'll just cover this whole thing up. I got the filler tube over there. Yeah. Yeah, that's what I'll do. So the boss just came out. Check things out. So I got that manhole all secured. I thought I was going to need another riser on it. Okay. But I don't. I can just cover right over top of it. And I got the fill pipe on and the vent pipe. It is Saturday, so you know what that means. I'm going to take the hunt man out somewhere. Then I'll come back and I'm going to put stone all around that manhole there.
Oh, really?
Just to protect it. So when, you know, you get those big chunks of shale and all that stuff. And that way, if I do that, I'll get to where I can run right beside it with the excavator once I get some cover on it and stuff. Okay. And get it all tamped in. But they're calling for rain, I think, this afternoon.
Oh, okay.
Or this evening. I'm not sure.
We better find out. Well, it might change, too.
That's one thing nice about this this fill that we brought in. It can rain on it, and like in a couple hours, it's dry. I got some stone around that manhole up there. Now I need some more dirt. But it's starting to get pretty overcast right now. I know it's supposed to rain this evening, but it appears that it may come a little sooner than later. We'll see. But in the last two videos, you've seen me haul this shale up there. So I think what I'm going to do is just shut the cameras off here for a bit, just move a bunch of dirt, and then I'll report back in a bit once I start spreading it around up there. The battery on the dump trailer is fully charged right now, so I should get at least 8 loads if it doesn't start raining hard before that. So that's the plan. I will report back in a little bit. I figured I'd check in with you here, let you know how I'm progressing. This is my 5th load right here. I got sidetracked there for a little bit, but it was pretty cool. Melissa made some lunch, kind of a late lunch, and I went in, and Hannah went and checked the PO box, and we got like 30 more license plates today, well, this week, and they're awesome. They really are. There's even some from Europe, Canada, some real old ones like from 1910, new ones. It's really, really interesting reading the notes that people are putting with them. And we really appreciate it. We're gonna be able to do like a whole wall or something in the game room when this is all said and done. So if you have any and you'd like to send them in, you can send them to Outdoors with the Morgans. That's P.O. Box 2140, Cranberry Township, PA. And Melissa's working on thank you notes as we speak. And she's also including some stickers with those, like the Split Happens sticker, Sawdust is Man Glitter sticker. But yeah, she sends a thank you note for every one of them. But yeah, we really appreciate it. That is going to be really neat one day, you know, to do a video kind of going through, picking random plates, reading who they're from and the story behind them. Pretty cool. But anyway, as I go with this little dirt moving project, you learn each time. You know, you get a little bit better the more you do something. Like, for example, I'm keeping the trailer closer to the excavator, and that's helping me to not spill anything on the side of the excavator. When it's too far away, you're reaching out, and even though you have the bucket curled all the way, it'll start dumping a little bit. So like this, I mean, I got a heaping bucket. I'll lift it up like this, just over top of the tailgate, spin it over, dump, nice and close. Works good. And I have the tailgate closed right now because I'm dumping these loads beside the building. So I kind of have to back in between the cistern tank and the posts there on the in the patio area. So I'm keeping the doors closed, but I've been able to do rounds in 15 minutes flat. That's start to finish, which isn't too bad. And you know, really, I only have, what is it? It's Saturday afternoon right now. And I started this Thursday night, little test there Thursday night, Friday night hauled some. And today, I probably only have 4 or 5 hours actually moving dirt up there. And it's actually going pretty good. If we don't get too much rain tonight, I should be able to finish it tomorrow, I think. Should be no problem. A lot of people said it'd be easier just to get someone to haul fill in, and it would be, but it's not always as easy as it sounds, you know? I called a couple people, and it all depends where they're working, if they're hauling those days. And once again, it's like we've talked about this before. Sometimes the more you can do yourself, the better off you are, you know? Nobody's gonna drop what they're doing around here when they're, you know, digging foundations or working for somebody else just to haul shale, you know, even if you pay for it. Everybody's busy, got things going on. So although this isn't the fastest method, I think this is gonna be my best option here. And, you know, say I have 10 hours in the whole thing, so what? Free dirt, got the equipment. And by the way, I've been loading these a little bit heavier. I'm probably getting 4 tons of load right now. But anyway, we'll take a couple more up there. The battery still seems to be holding up okay. I imagine I'll get about 8 loads. Right now, I'm just kind of breaking up the sides a little bit. This stuff's pretty hard and getting ready for when I come back down. Yeah, that's nice stuff. I want to show you something here. A friend of mine, Tom, he watches our channel. He made this for me. Heck, it's been 2 years now. Yeah, something like that. Works great, though. Trying to sprinkle a little bit right now.
Mike's brought up six trailers full of fill and dumped them, and then the trailer needed charge. So the trailer's parked over there charging, and he's on the excavator right now leveling out the fill that he brought up. It's starting to sprinkle. So they did forecast some rain for Saturday afternoon, evening. Doesn't look to be like too much, and this might just sprinkle for a while and move on. Not sure. So on my channel, Morgan's Off the Leash, we do a Saturday Night Live every other Saturday. So tonight is gonna be Saturday Night Live. When you see this video, go to Morgan's Off the Leash and check it out. You might be interested, it might be entertaining to you. Also watch our most recent video, number 60. It's got some surprise information in there that we're gonna talk about tonight on Saturday Night Live. Okay, so as Mike finishes up here, I'm gonna finish up this video. Thanks so much for being here, for subscribing, for liking and commenting. We'd love to hear from you. Also, everyone that's been sending the license plates in, thank you so much. We'll be sending out those thank yous soon, but I want you to know we really appreciate it. It's gonna be exciting to have those hanging on the wall in the new building. All right, we'll see you on the next one. Thanks.